I am the creative lady, aka Nappylicious TV. In tonight's video, I'm gonna share something with you guys. A couple days ago, I was about to toss out into the recycle bin this empty Peach Bellini Bath and Body Works gentle foaming hand soap dispenser, and something said, hey, fill me back up with some soap and try to make it foam again. I'm like, girl, what? So we normally have, just as a refill, this Mrs. Meyer's hand soap refill, and this is the basil scent. And we have it in a normal, it's like this, but this is a lotion, but it's in a little bottle like this. Filled it up, y'all, with about this much soap, and then the rest was water. And it does foam up, so I'll show you. And because, you know, we're doing a lot of washing of our hands, and so it does foam up. And you see, this is not a foamy soap. So I'm like, okay, so now I wanted to try something different. So I ordered these little dispensers from Amazon, and I got three of them. And so I was like, okay, well, let's see if it's going to work. These are white. Let's give it a try tonight with the new little dispensers. And they came in a 3-pack from Amazon. I'll leave them linked down below. And they also come with some labels, you know, so you can say what's in there, whether it's hand sanitizer or if it's soap or whatever it is, okay? So let's try it here tonight. So I can't really see how much it is to add, but I am going to try it with a different soap, okay? Just to see if it's really going to work. And this is some soap that I've had on hand. You can't see how much I've used, but this is from, I think I got this at Sprouts a while ago, but this is the Alafia Authentic Black Soap with Shea Butter and Neem Leaf with Lavender and Lang Lang. It's a 4-in-1 for all skin types. It's a body wash, a face cleanser, hand soap, and it's good for shaving. And, you know, I'll leave it linked if I can find it down in my Amazon shop as well. But I know I got this, I believe, at Sprouts. So let's see if we can make this work with this soap, okay? And I'm going to pour about a third of the way with, can't really see, but it's probably about right here, okay? And I've got some water. Normally, of course, I'm in the bathroom, but I've got some water just laying around, okay? So let's fill it up with water, okay? I don't know, it's about, I filled it up with water to about here, okay? Just to give it a little more room to do whatever it might need to do. I don't know if this is going to work or not, okay? It's got that little spring action going. Key would be not to fill it up with water all the way, because I did experience a little spillage, and I didn't even fill it all the way to the top. So I would say leave a little room for expansion for the water. Okay, so let's shake it up, because I did shake up the one that I tried. So let's see if this is going to work. A couple of pumps. Oh, I hear something, y'all. Let's see together. Ooh, it's working. It turns it into foaming soap, y'all. Okay, and it's a good rich lather. Look at that. Okay, so y'all might want to get y'all some of these if you've got some, whatever kind of soap you've got, okay? If you got the liquid hand sanitizer. Well, I turned this into, I got foamy hand soap on me, but yeah, I turned this regular soap, it's, you know, multi-purpose, into foaming hand soap. And I bet this would work with the Dr. Bronner's. Matter of fact, I got some Dr. Bronner's, and I think I got one more bottle, so let's give it a go. So hold on, y'all. Let's get back and see if it'll work with the Dr. Bronner's. Be right back. Okay, y'all, I'm back, and I've got my Dr. Bronner's. This is the 18-in-1 Hemp Lavender Pure Castile Soap. You can purchase anywhere, okay, that sells Castile soaps. And I have another Bath and Body Works empty container, and this one was the Fresh Sparkling Snow. Okay, so I have this one. This is the 8.75 fluid ounce, if it matters. So let's go ahead, and you can see it happening as we do it. So, because it's clear, so I'm gonna fill it up with soap to about maybe bath, and so we'll see. I'm gonna pour some soap in here, and let's see. Okay, to about right there. Alrighty. And you know, I believe the soap is concentrated, so you don't have to worry about it being too weak. Once we add the water, we'll see. So now I got a little bit more water here, and we're not going to fill it all the way to the top, right? So let's go ahead and add. We only got about that much water, so whatever we've got. Okay, that's about where I would like to stop it, okay? So now we're going to put the pump back inside. And there's just something about the magic of these foaming soaps. And when I did it the last time, when I made the first one, I shook it up just to get it going, okay? All right, y'all, so let's see if this one is going to work, okay? Ooh, I'm kind of nervous, y'all. Action. Okay. Oh, look, we got foaming soap, y'all. And you know, Dr. Bronner's is not necessarily a foaming soap, and there was no residual in the pump. Okay, just to be sure, we'll pump out some more. Okay, see that? We've got foaming soap. Okay, foaming soap. Wasting this good soap, y'all. But anything for y'all, okay? Is how I have upcycled this bottle from the Bath and Body Works foaming collection to make new foaming hand soap. I must give you a disclaimer, y'all. Look, this right here I thought was going to work the other night, and I'm like, oh, I can make another one. I didn't really pay attention, but I did notice that the pumps were different. But I'm like, well, you know, sometimes companies change their branding. But this one is not a foaming hand soap. This is just a regular hand soap. But reading is fundamental, so I had to look to see that it was not foaming. So always, if you want to have the foaming action, make sure that you either order the ones online, or if you're upcycling, make sure that it has this type of top and that it says foaming in the actual, you know, verbiage on the bottle. But you could probably use some of your, you know, recyclable things. Like, this is not empty yet, but I don't know about you, but I've got plenty of these mousse type containers that turn, you know, foamy once you use them. So if you got some of these, you might want to try it. I mean, clean them out, of course, but give that a try. So if you can take the top off, not all of them, you can take the top off, and this is one of those that screws off and you can fill it back up. So whatever magic is in between here and there, it makes it foam up. All right, y'all, I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to my channel. Smash that notification bell. Join me on Napalicious TV, and may your heart be squeaky clean and filled with purple joy. Bye, y'all.